To our first flipped classroom. I hope you can hear me today. If not, tell me in class and we'll have to adjust some things. We're going to start today with our first lesson, and it is about algebraic expressions. And I'm going to explain what that means. And we're going to skip all the way to chapter 5. This is lesson 5-1. So that's what you need to start out writing in your notes. Algebraic means we're going to use numbers and variables. And expressions means there's no equal sign. So you may want to put that in parentheses. There's no equal sign. So we're just writing an expression. So I want to show you some examples of some expressions. 6r. That means 6 times r. We are not going to write this R6 or R.6 or R and then an X6 or the opposite way, 6.R or 6 times R. Those are old ways of writing it. Here's the best one right here, 6R. Okay, 9ST. That means 9 times S times T. All right, another one, MN. That means M times N. I also have this one here, A cubed. That means, and you can write this down, A times A times A. Now, when we look at these, I want to talk about a number that is the coefficient. And what that means is the number in front. So we're going to go back and we're going to underline the coefficient in these expressions. So when I look up here at these expressions, 6 times r, 6r, the coefficient is 6. When I look at the next one, 9 times s times t, 9 is the coefficient. Now it gets a little confusing. I have mn, there's no number in front of there. So what is the coefficient? Well, any time that you don't have one, you can just pretend that there's a 1 there, because that doesn't change the value. 1 times something is the same as if the 1 isn't there. So the coefficient here is 1, and the same thing for a cubed, a times a times a. You can pretend there's the 1 there, so that 1 is the coefficient. So those are expressions. They're algebraic because they have letters with them, or variables. Call them variables. Also, your secret word that you need to write down is otter. All right, moving on, and this is going to go nicely with what we just did. We're going to evaluate some expressions. And to evaluate means that we solve them. We find the answer. All right, so I'm going to tell you first that we are going to let B equal 3 and W equal 5. And I'm going to give you 3 expressions, and we're going to solve 2 of them together, and then one of them is going to be your secret problem. So, number 1, 8W minus 2V. So what we're going to do is we're going to substitute those numbers in and then use order of operations to work it out. Now, what's W? It's 5, so I'm going to rewrite this, and I'm going to write 8 times 5. It doesn't mean 85. It means to multiply. Minus 2 times, well, what's V? It's 3. 8 times 5 is 40. 2 times, because I do multiplication before I do subtraction, 2 times 3 is 6, 40 minus 6 is 34. So when I evaluate that expression, I get 34 for my answer. All right, number 2, I'm going to take 3w squared. All right, so I'm going to evaluate that expression. So I have to put 5 in for w. So I'm going to rewrite this, 3 times 5 squared. Now let's think, in order of operations, what do I do first? Do I multiply or do I use exponents? PEMDAS, let's see, parentheses, exponents. So the first thing I do 25, and 3 times 25 is 75. So when I evaluate 3w squared, I get 75. All right, here's the secret problem. You're going to still use this right here, and I want you to evaluate this, and I'm going to write it down here in red. I want you to evaluate 2v squared minus 3w, and I want to see the work. I don't just want to see the answer, okay? I hope you enjoyed our first video of the flipped classroom, and we'll see you in class on Friday. Thanks for watching. Bye.